Hi everyone. I'm gonna try something new. Having no idea if the technical stuff is okay. I'm just gonna hope it is. When I join this tournament, I can tell you what I'm hoping is gonna happen. I hope I'm gonna have a blank screen in front of me. And then I'm gonna turn off my other screen. And in theory, then you should be able to see the game, whereas I'm playing with the blank screen. Okay. Let's hope this works. So now I'm turning off the screen. Everybody's saying you can hear and hear me okay. Turning off this screen. Then going off here. And now joining the tournament. And if I did everything correctly, I'm gonna get a game. And I'm gonna not really see my pieces. Yeah, there is a blindfold option in lichess, and I've activated it. So I'm hoping it works. And I'm hoping that I'm actually being able to give you the board. Okay, so now it's blank and I'm playing e4. Okay, it does work. It's kind of cheating because I can see the last five moves here, but I think we're just gonna have to live with that. So it's a Russian opening. He went out with his queen a little bit too early on e7. I think his knight is still on e4, so I'm gonna go after it. That was not a good move. Now I got the pin on the e-file, the attack towards the knight on e4, and d3 should take it. Unless, can he castle? No. That is a queen, not a bishop. I'm gonna take this one. So I'm just a piece up. Okay, and it's working. I tried finding my pop out my chat, being a beginner, move list while playing. This looks so weird. Yeah, I agree. It looks kind of weird. But can you see the moves? If you could confirm in the chat, can you actually see the moves in the other diagram? Because that's kind of the intention. I had this idea that somebody should do blindfold chess. Well, basically it's the only thing nobody has done, streaming chess, right? Or not that I could find, at least. That's a blunder. I'm really hoping he gives up. Because I don't really know. I kind of lost control over where the pieces are. But I know I'm a queen up, so I'm thinking it should be okay. Can you see the board? Yeah, you can see the moves. Chess bra can do it. Of course chess bra can do it. Ah, chess network has done it. Ah, so much for trying to be original, huh? Yeah, that's too bad. But it's gonna be fun. Gonna be fun. Let's see. I used my knight here to take the queen. His rook threatening my queen. Probably my rooks are connected. And where's his knight? Okay, I shouldn't make any big moves. Let's just go here. Ah, so the board. Right, yeah. That's good. So at least some points for originality. Bishop here. Probably threatening my rook. But I think his knight is on c6. Right? And I have a queen on c1. Okay, I'm gonna take a gamble. Shit. Okay, it's not letting me take on that c6. That's not good. That means I don't know where my pieces are. My bishop. I took... Let's just make a move before we lose on time. I played c3, exchanging off bishop. He castles. My knight has been exchanged. Right? And his knight is on c6. Yeah. So why couldn't I take on c6? I have a bishop on f4, rook on e4, bishop on f3, right? Yeah, probably. And a pawn on e5. See, I have two pieces here. He has two pieces. Oh, darn. He has a pawn? No. God, this should be fine. No pawn on h6, right? Hoping there's no pawn on h6. Okay. Let's go with this guy. So now there's a knight on c6. Bishop on f3. I mean, I took back, but it didn't let me take on c6 the last time. Did I give away my bishop for something? This is check, right? I have no bishop on f3. Ah, there's the explanation. That's kind of a fault with the program, right? That I actually, yeah, I understood my bishop was on g4, but because I was not allowed to play queen g3. Okay, so the system, I guess, is not perfect. Kind of difficult to be perfect, I guess. Could he have taken that? Okay. Wasn't his rook an f8? Okay, next game I'm gonna focus from the beginning, because here I just lost complete track. Okay, he resigned. But more focus next game. What are people saying? Howler, did I do something wrong? Yeah, I was taking a bit too long, right? Sophisticated setup. That's very cool. That's very nice of you to say. Yeah, kind of funny. It's funny until you completely forget where the pieces are. And then it's not so funny anymore. So it's an English opening, this much I know. So long as we're in theory, I'm pretty confident about where the pieces are. It's your turn. Come on. D3. Controlling the center. Interesting, but not very good. Now, if I'm not completely mistaken, can go here, trading off the bishop for the knight, enabling me to get this pretty nice square on d4. Huh, he castled. It's pretty much asking for it, right? But my knight is so good. Yeah, okay, I'll go here. Yeah, maybe I should have taken it. P3, that's not a good move. Think. I was slightly worried he would play something like. On up to F4. Let's just go here. He left? Oh, come on. Okay. Next game. I was winning, to be fair. Getting a challenge. No, I want to play in the tournament. Right? I should check the chat. Frozen. Frozen, that's not good. Is it frozen? No, I don't think it's frozen. It looks good to me. I'm turning off the other screen again. Lopez. Still frozen? All good? Frozen? That's not good. Yeah, it should be fine if you refresh, people are saying. And this is not a very good pawn structure on the queen side. And then, in addition, black is just a pawn down. I'm not gonna fall for that one. Let's try to be slightly tricky. If bishop a7, I'm gonna give myself some horrendous pawns. What's bishop e3, but I'm gonna get this really nice square on c5, which I'm hoping is gonna be more than enough. Ooh, pre-moving, that's sweet. Knight here, and now if rook b8, I have knight d7, so he better not do that. Is my pawn on a3 or a2? I'm gonna go rook d7. Basically, this bishop on a8 is completely dead, and I'm gonna play b4 to bolster my knight on c5. And then I'm gonna, darn. I'm really hoping my I'm really hoping my pawn is on a3. A3. I played a3 to stop him from going bishop b4. Yeah, I think it's on. We'll find out soon enough. Yeah, it was on a3. Very good. Now I'm gonna play c3 just to make sure. And now trading off the rooks is gonna help me win the bishop in the corner. So he doesn't want to. But now. Yeah, I think I'm actually gonna trade the rooks. And now just push the pawn. He's completely, his queen side is just, he can't get his pieces up. And my pawn is quite dangerous. My king is safe. My pawn is safe. His king not so safe. So let's go with the king. Okay. So far so good. Wait, what? Ah, he had the double G pawns. I forgot about that. This is the king, but I'm coming with my king. Ta-da. It's a very nice game with the bishop on a8, completely out of the game, and with the knight very powerful helping out. Rook g7 looks a lot like checkmate with knight d7 next. Mate in 2, actually. Let's see how he can stop it. Checkmate. Very nice. No, I don't have any mods. I'm sorry. I'm new to Twitch. Blindfold Berserk. Yeah, I probably could do that, but it being the first time, I thought I should take it easy. It's so stressful, this berserking. Just really wanted to test this out, if it actually did work, which it does seem. It does seem like it does. So that's nice. Play this move, I think. Gonna put the bishop back here. Yeah, I was kind of hoping you wouldn't play that. The rook is on e1, probably. I'll just play this. I guess I should play g5 and hope that he doesn't take. It's always so shaky when you play g5. Okay, let's go. Ah, you don't take on g5. Maybe you should have actually. But now I'm gonna play. Maybe knight h5, maybe knight e5 works. Take there and go. No, it's too shaky. I should make a move. Knight h5, knight e5. Take back, take here. I should make a move. Okay, let's just make this move before I lose some time. I'm not sure my position is that good, actually. Knight a3. It's interesting. But the bishop is in c4. I really want to play knight h5, but I'm not sure it's possible. Oh, let's just make a move before I lose some time. Knight going here and then there. That's a very good plan, actually. And it's a plan I have no idea what to do against. Okay, let's just play this move and hope you don't take on e5. That's pretty desperate. Ah, you didn't take an e5. Yeah, but then I'm quite happy about my position, actually. Reasonably happy, at least. Take that one. I'm gonna take with this one. Yeah, because now I got everything I wanted with the dark squared bishop in the corner, and then pointing up towards the center. Potential for attack on the king side. Bad is happening here. Now he opened up for my bishop, so that's gonna be a problem for him in the future. And this one I can take, right? quite sure what his idea is. I'll go... Okay, I'll just go here. I was a bit concerned about Queen D5. Ah, darn. Okay. I'll take that one. You take that one. Ah, this is not good. This is not good. Especially with my time. It's soon time to panic. Very soon time to panic. Okay, that square is safe. And next I'll go with this rook. Then I'll go hide in the corner. I'm really low on time, huh? Yeah, I thought you might do that. I thought you might. Ah, his rook is an e1, probably. Blindfold pre-moving, that's the first. I should have gone back. Probably okay. Oh, what happened? Oh, I thought he had his rook in a6. Ah, okay, good game. Wait, I have to... Okay, it doesn't matter, I'm losing on time anyway. Resign, yeah. Okay, that was not good. That was not good. Yeah, I was wondering, what is common practice with the moderators? Do you normally just pick someone in the audience to kind of take charge? Okay, I'm gonna be really boring. I'm just gonna take this. Let's play this move. Someone you trust, huh? Yeah, it would be nice to have somebody you trust. Okay, so I'm just gonna get my pieces out slowly but surely. Now I'm attacking on e5. What happens if I right click? I'm attacking this pawn. So he's gonna have to protect it somehow. And he did. And then I'm just gonna have to go on with the life. So he played b5. That's probably a weakening move. I'm gonna want to play a4 at some point. Or did I want to do that? Okay, it's done. So he needs to move his bishop to get connection between the rooks. That was not a good move. Now I'm very happy about this square for the knight. And also this one is helping me attack the pawn on e5. So now he basically has to move his knight back, right? Because otherwise I just take this one. It seems to be a bit mismatch. Either I got the game that was very difficult, and now I'm just getting the slightly cooperative games. Exchange of knights. That's an interesting proposal, but I think I'm gonna have to decline. So there's a knight on d7, a bishop on e6, queen on e7, now a rook on d8. So I have more control than normal, I think. And the pawn structure here is a bit strange. That one is gonna also be slightly strange. I'll take the opportunity to try to put my knight here on f5. Or maybe I want to go f4. Moving the knight gave me both options, so I could pick and choose as I like. Yeah, I was actually threatening to go forward, trapping the bishop on e6. So he played f5. My pieces. So probably I'm going to start out by taking this. He's going to take back, and I'm going to take this bishop. Then go with. No surprises now. Now with the rook, I'm threatening something here. My pawn is under attack here. Where's my queen? Probably on d1. And now I can go with my queen to f3. So I have a bishop here, a rook here, a rook here, and a queen here, a king here-ish. And I'm a pawn up with a bishop on the long diagonal. This is looking very good. I might be threatening a pawn here. I'm not sure I want to take that. Did he play a6? He didn't play a6. That's how he got into trouble. Okay. I'm very tempted to go. Ooh, no, 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 no. Oh, this is nice. Oh, this is for the camera. I'm gonna take an h5. Oh, I gotta take that one. I think it works. So now I'm hoping there's a rook. Yeah. There was a rook on f8, which meant that he only could go into the corner, and then I have the discovered check. That was nice. That was sweet. Yeah, I think I have my king on g1, but I'm not gonna take any chances. I'm a rook up, right? I took the knight, and he just had, and I got the rook. Probably he's threatening here. But also, I should have checkmate. No. Ah, I didn't have a pawn on h4. Maybe I should get a pawn on h4. Threatening checkmate here. So he's gonna have to go back to c6 at some point, and then I'm gonna go with the king here, and I got him pretty trapped. Threatening mate here and here, and if he moves the rook, sometimes here. Checkmate. That was fun. Queen takes h5. Queen takes h5. For the camera, yeah. I didn't get more of a bus after queen h5? Come on! Queen h5, that was fantastic. That was odd. Oh well. Next game. Queen takes h5. Come on. That was so nice. So nice. I'm not gonna have a blindfold game like that anytime soon. Shouldn't he castle soon? He refuses to castle. He took this one. I don't think that's very clever. And then just gonna go back, and then eventually I'll chase the knight away with my pawn. And in the meantime, I have this square where there's no black pieces can chase my bishop away. Now I can chase his. And then put b4. Opening up a second flank. Let's see. I'll go here. Knight back. Surely something is in trouble now. I'll take this one. Has to take back with a pawn. I'm kind of tempted just to go c4 and just say, look at this bishop. But is it a good move? Maybe I should go a4 instead. Ah, taking on a4. Queen is on c7. Yeah, but that one is protected by my... So I'm gonna go here. So my bishop is dominating the light squares. I can see what you're doing, because I remember I have a queen here. I did remember that. I'm not gonna fall for those tricks. And now this knight is dominated. And I'm just gonna pick up what I can. There's a pawn here I'm interested in. I don't think you can do that. And now if rook takes d5, I can take on e7. Take care. I'm pretty sure I played h3. So there's no back rank made and he resigned. Okay, this was fun. Rook takes e6. Another one. And we're gonna do another tourney in a bit. Can't see pieces on the left side of the screen. That's actually kind of the point. I'm playing blindfold chess. It was a joke. Yeah, I'm not playing in Baku. I didn't qualify. So that was too bad. Yeah, queen takes h5. Yeah, I said that was gonna be good. Yeah, I was really happy about queen h5. Maybe not best move ever, but it was up there. Can't touch this. Yeah, I'm afraid to sing it. I could get into some copyright issues. I heard that MC Hammer lost all his money. Vegas, or I'm actually gonna comment on the Blitz and Rapid. So I'm not playing myself, but I'm gonna be following it very closely. Yeah, thanks. It was actually I didn't realize that I didn't realize it was the last round when I played against Jon Bartholomew. I'm commenting Blitz and Rapid at a Norwegian outlet, so there's still a chance you might get to enjoy Komarov. For the championship. Yeah, I'll remember to turn off the blindfold. Yeah. Actually, I thought I wanted actually to do half an hour more. I think there's another Blitz tournament starting. I haven't completely learned this lichess thing, but I think they have tournaments going all the time. So I'm gonna join the next one as well. Cause I mean I wanna be fighting for the tournament victory playing Blindfold. I don't wanna be just, you know, sitting there getting some nice combinations, but still. Chess commentator. Well, I like Svidler. I mean, I love Svidler as a person, and you know, when he starts talking, he cannot stop. But you know, he's also very, he can be complicated at times, but for me, that's, you know, just perfect, because I'm trying to soak up all his knowledge, basically. So yeah, Svidler, that's going to be my pick. Combinations. Queen h5. If you didn't see queen h5, try to rewind. That was, you know, that was my biggest Blindfold moment. Pretty much any time. Whistles. Yeah, I haven't noticed that. Okay, so. Shit. He berserked me. Did you see that? Wow. Against me? That never happened. I've done it to other people, but I've never seen anyone do it against me. Wow. This is a brave guy. Threatening my bishop. I'm not gonna fall for that one. He's playing really fast. Where's my pieces? This move, I think you're gonna get into trouble. And this one, pre-moving. Really? With the bishop here and my bishop here? Okay, you only live once, right? Please tell me my bishop is protecting that one. Ah, it wasn't. Ah, it wasn't. Okay. Check. There's still chances. Ah, I forgot he played h6. Okay, but now, I mean, this one with the queen. Yeah, we got the piece back. We got the piece back, I hope. Yeah, I think I'm good. Where's the pieces? He has a knight here, and a knight here, and a bishop here. And I have, I sacrificed a knight here. Yeah, and so when I take this knight, I have two bishops left, right? And I'm gonna get this guy back as fast as possible. And now he's left with pieces here and here. And then going back with the bishop. I'm gonna watch out for checkmate here. Yeah, I thought you were gonna do that. So I'm gonna watch out for that one. Now he's got, so I'm a pawn up. Ah, but he has connections between his rooks. Maybe I should have gone h6 actually. Okay, so he has a bishop here, but he has a pawn here. So if I now go here, that should be fine. Unless, yeah, okay, that should be fine. If he could take my queen, he would have done so already. So he wants to double, but then I'm gonna give a check here. Right? Yeah, maybe I'm slightly nervous about that. Either way. Because now he's escaping. And he has his knight here. And my king. It's not fantastic. And he's actually crushing me on time. That's making me kind of stressed out. You know what? Let's just evacuate, I think. No, let's not. This pawn. It's not really much I can do about that. So I should just leave it be. I should evacuate my king. Okay, let's try this one. Defending blindfolded. That's tough. I'm concerned about e5 and then bishop g4. Or e5 and then. Yeah, I'm concerned about e5. I'm not too concerned about that move. Because now I kind of get my king out of the way. Yeah, and he had to go back, so he kind of just wasted a move. But my king is not good. Here. It's not. So I should try to. But it's okay, I guess. Let's try to go here. Ooh, I did not see that one. I did not see that one. Okay. Aha! Ha, you did not see that one. Okay, so he's gonna try to keep fighting. No. Yeah, okay, I'll go here. You know what? Let me just take this one. And now I should be just a clean piece up. Probably with a passed pawn as well. And then it should just be some slight conversion issues. Checkmate. Queen takes h8. I'm pretty happy about that one too. Pretty happy about that one. That was good. So as for fighting for first place, we won a game, but probably we're gonna have to beat this guy, killercars, in order to stop him from streaking. Okay, should I berserk? No, okay, I'm just gonna go. No, wait, yeah, I'm black. Okay, I don't wanna play that move then. Then I wanna go here. Yeah, that's actually an issue. I when the game starts, I can't see whether I'm black or white, so I'm gonna have to pay some attention. Let's try this one. coffee and cheddar. Maybe I should have berserked. But that means I have time to check the chat. Chess videos on YouTube. I've actually almost never seen a chess video on YouTube before the streamer challenge. And for the streamer challenge, I started checking out the competition, basically. So I've been looking at some of the, what's his name? And also the chess bro and the John Bartholomew streams. Now, this one. Pre-move. Ah, I may have blundered a pawn. If he takes this one, take back, he can go queen f4. Yeah, okay. Okay, but that's fine. Queen f4, maybe I can go knight d3. And then there's a pawn here on b2. Maybe slightly risky to grab that one, but I really like my pawns. So I don't want to lose. I don't want to lose one of them. So now he's trying to trap this one. And if queen d3, then he takes my knight with check. So that means I should actually move my knight. Now, my plan was actually not to move the knight. My plan was to go here. But on second thought, I'm really concerned about that move. That's not good. Really not good. I shouldn't be so greedy. Okay, so if knight takes c4, then knight d5 is the problem. And then he's probably also threatening knight c7 on top of, you know, other bad stuff. Okay, so I'm gonna have to try to take this anyway. Then after knight d5, protect my knight with... Okay. Where are my pieces? I have a knight here and a rook here. They are both hanging. But if I go with my bishop here, I protect both of them. Good move. I'll go here. Threatening the knight. I think he's gonna notice that. But now I'm a pawn up. So what do you do when you're a pawn up? You start moving your pawns forward. I'll do this and hope that he doesn't go here. Yeah. Good gamble. Because now I'll just continue with my pawn forward. No, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to go here. So he has a knight here and a knight here, rook here, rook here, queen here. I got the board under control. I got more time than him. I think we're going for another win. And I'm threatening to go knight e3. But that too, I do think he will notice. Queen e2. You want queen e2? That's going to make it really tempting to go f5. Exchanging queens. Yeah, I'm going to do that. So knight g5, I'll exchange queens. He's gonna take back on e2, and then I'm gonna move the bishop so that we don't have any accidents. Ooh, knight d4. Well, he could have gone knight d4 with a double threat here and here. Instead, he went knight f4, but that's... that I can easily parry with my rook to e8. My rook is on e8. Hmm, interesting. Yeah, that's true, because the queen was attacking. Okay, so then I don't have to move my rook to e8. It's kind of cheating when there are moves that don't work. You shouldn't have that kind of help. Actually, you know, they had blindfold tournaments in Amber, Melody Amber, in Monaco. And I actually don't know how those computers were programmed. But I think then, whenever you made a move that was illegal, you were just told that that move was illegal. And you weren't told, you know, why it was illegal or anything like that. So my knight is here. I have a rook here and a rook here. And I'm low on time, but so is he. And I'm expecting him to go knight d4, threatening my pawn. And I'll protect my pawn. Okay. That was a good move. I'll go here. That was maybe not a good move. That was certainly not a good move. Now I have, I think that works. I think it's checkmate. I hope that works. And now I'm hoping there's a back rank mate. Yeah, sounds like it, because he's not moving. Ooh, nice going. Okay, 2 out of 2. But we're really lagging behind the best ones because they are finishing their games so much faster. Okay. But now we're on the streak. So now we're gonna get the points really fast. And I guess we can hope to stop some of the other people on a streak. Okay, black. We'll try a different opening this time, even though we were so successful the first time around. Okay, we're gonna try this one. I like this one.
when I was younger, much younger than today. Yeah, I don't remember that move being a thing. Maybe it was, actually. Okay, potentially this is gonna be just a complete disaster. Okay, so knight takes e5. I'm gonna play d5. But then there's a check here. And, well, basically anything could happen. Nah, I think I'm good. I think this is what I'm supposed to play. So maybe bishop b5 is more critical in a way. Yeah, he's going for it, but I think I got it under control. Maybe we can get a quick win. Or a quick loss. Either way, it's gonna be quick. Yeah, and now I'll take that one. And I'll take that one. And we're gonna have to do a count of the pieces. Okay, I have no idea where anything is. It's such an unusual position. That really messes up kind of how I think about the game. Okay, we're gonna have a little trap. Threatening the check with the bishop. And then he'll lose his queen. Or if he has a pawn on d4. Does he have a pawn on d4? I don't think so. I really don't think he has a pawn on d4. Let's go. Yeah. Okay, kind of cheating again, because, you know, the computer was telling me that it was check and so on. But I'll talk to the lichess guy and we can sort this out. Claim a victory. Very good. Okay, we're fighting for a win in the tournament. Ooh, but there's another guy who's berserking like crazy. Okay, but if we beat this Hens guy, I think we can win the tournament. Any comments? Not enough of a handicap. So you think I should start berserking. Okay, this time I'm white. Oh, I'm actually, oh wow, I'm playing at 2300. Ooh, that's gonna be tough. Ah, but he's playing the Berlin. You shouldn't play the Berlin against me. That's a big mistake. Big mistake. I'm gonna play this like Vishwanathan Anand. I think he does this and then this. So you're not supposed to do that move, are you? Let me try this one. I was younger. Okay. Interesting. I'll go here. He'll have to go back with his bishop, right? I'm gonna try this move. May not have been the best one. Okay, he's probably gonna go knight d5. Yeah. Okay, I'll take that one. Go with the king. Okay, probably I didn't play this very well. But oh well. I'll go here. Ah, f6 now. Yeah. Or actually, even h5 is good. Yeah, okay. The Berlin is a very good opening. I play it myself. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, we'll try this one. Yeah. Okay, let's go into desperate mode. Just trying to salvage a draw. That's not too good. Okay, but he at least, when you can't be happy yourself, you can at least make your opponent unhappy as well. He's spending a bit of time. Yeah, I guess I should moderate the chat slightly. Okay, won't go back. Anyone who made a sensible comment quite a bit earlier and then now is willing to do the moderating, say I. Because I have an image to uphold. I cannot have such an unwily chat. Okay, I'm actually almost feeling good about this again. His bishop is a bit out of play here, so I'm hoping to get my king up. This bishop is still out of play. And also there's a trick, if he plays g6, I might be able to go e6. Okay, this is actually becoming quite interesting. Yeah, but he's getting his king here. I'll try this. Yeah, probably not very good. Maybe it was actually. I'm reasonably close of getting something here. Ah, so close. This, then I guess I'll go here. Ah, so close to queening. I guess he'll go g5. I don't really have a plan against that. Draw? Would you like a draw? I offer a draw. Actually, I can flag him, no? Okay, he doesn't want to draw, that's kind of odd. Where's my pieces? I can go here, no? What you gonna do? What you gonna do, guy? I'm taking your rook. Okay. This is looking good. This is looking very good. Sorry, victory. Yeah, so who said? The Musidan. Can we trust this guy saying that the Musidan is such an upstanding guy? I don't see the Musidan commenting anything. Clever. Mic drop? Reverse psychology. Yeah. I'm quite a sucker for that. Okay, let's do another Ruy Lopez. Now we're, you know, we're in it. In it to win it. Okay, I guess we'll play some theoretical stuff. If I can remember this stuff, that is. Bishop b7. I do not know that move. Maybe I should know that move. Let's try to protect this pawn. Protect this. Okay, maybe okay, if he now plays knight e4, I can go d5. And there's some ideas which should win a piece. Ah, he took. He took. Yeah. Okay. And now he goes knight a5. Threatening my bishop and also starting. Okay. I'll have to go here. I think it's the only way I can save my pawn. So now I actually have a choice. Do I want to take back with a pawn? I'm gonna be funky. I'm gonna take with a pawn. I don't have a pawn here. Wow. Okay, I should take with the queen then. Ah, yeah, because I played a4. Let's take with the rook. So there's already been tons of exchanges, which I'm guessing I should be pretty happy about. Less pieces to lose track of. But I do feel he's getting some pressure against the e4 pawn. Uh-oh. Was that a mistake? I think I should be fine. It's slightly complicated, but we're gonna trade some stuff. I think I'm a pawn up. Not for long, but a pawn up. Ban everyone. I'm not sure that's a good thing. Yeah, but I probably should do something. After this game, I promise, I'll take a look at this. So I'm a pawn up, right? No. Yeah, I'm a pawn up. I'm very happy about being a pawn up. I'm not sure I'm gonna stay a pawn up for very long. Because this guy is in trouble. And also my king, not doing too great. Okay, I mean, I might be greedy, but knight b5, is that not a new pawn for me? I know I'm greedy, but he's just handing them to me. Trust your instincts. That's actually very good advice. Trust your instincts. Okay, so if now he checks, I can go back. No problem. Protected by the knight. I hope. So he went there. Now I can. Yeah, but then I'm gonna lose this one. Um, Okay, I'm gonna be cheeky. I'm gonna go here. Ooh, that was a mistake. Ooh, big mistake. I missed rook a8. I missed rook a8. He's not gonna miss that. Ooh, that's not good. Ah, so close. We were doing so well. Yeah, now if queen b6, there's a fork on d5. So close. What's my best chance of drawing? Time, probably. In time. I'm gonna try to keep hold on to that pawn as long as I can, but it's not gonna be very long. And then I'm just, you know, gonna hope that my knight somehow can save me miraculously. Okay, come on. What are you doing, guy? Oh, come on, I'm winning. Oh, winning is maybe a bit too strong, but I'm saving this. I saved it. Close call, but okay, he's playing on. That's cheeky. Might not be the cleverest thing he did. Okay. Almost won. Let's return to tournament and yeah. Let's hope that fixes. I did say I was a sucker for reverse psychology. It worked this time. Well, this I'm gonna do. Ben Feingold. How often do you get a person you actually trust to weed out the stuff? Bishop, this. Maybe I'm supposed to take this one. I always wondered what happens if queen checks. Maybe this is the game I'll find out. No. Okay. So already I'm liking my position very much. I'm gonna take this pawn, and then he just didn't protect it. No, he didn't take it back, I mean. So I'm just gonna protect. Serve and protect. That's something else. And I'll take this one actually, and I'll stop the ideas of bishop. Oh, that's the wrong one. The ideas of bishop g4. And I'm gonna keep hold on to this guy as long as I can. I don't think that was very clever. Let's go here. Attacking this one. Maybe I should have tried berserking. I did win all my games, right? Nah, the draw. And the draw also messed up our bonus thingy. That's too bad. Knight d4 seems tempting. Threatening this one and this one. Pretty much forcing bishop d7. And then I'm gonna go b4. What just happened? But that was only a pawn, right? This is a piece. Is he threatening? Knight e4. I'll go back. Yeah. No, I don't think this one is hanging. So, I'm a piece up. That's good news. Maybe we can win the tournament. How far behind are we? Oh, we're way behind. Wow. Really way behind. Okay, I have a knight here and a bishop here and a knight here. He has a bishop here and a knight here. So, I mean, this should work, no? I have a knight here, which is now under attack. I should go here. There's a pawn hanging here, but if he takes it, then I take his knight. Because I think his rook is still in f8. Probably is. Yeah. Speaking of, yeah, it was. So this is actually giving me some time to do whatever I want. And what do I want to do? I'd like to play my knight back. Let's just take this one. I'm slightly concerned about this move. I don't know where I should put my knight then. That move I'm not concerned about because I think I have a check here. Do I have a pawn on h3? I don't know if I have a pawn on h3, so I'm gonna go knight g4 just in case I don't. Because otherwise I would exchange and go knight g4. But I'm not sure I have a pawn on h3. There. Well, that pretty much proves that I don't have a pawn on h3, because if he's willing to take that pawn structure, it probably means my knight is trapped. So I'll just go... Ah, that explains it. I tried going h3 and it couldn't. So that means I can't take that one. Go back. Still concerned about this c4 move, but now at this point I think I'm just so many pieces up, pieces at the very least, pawns and one piece. He has a knight here, a bishop here, and I think rooks here and here. And I got it under control. Right there, that one I think I can take. Now let's just go defense, blocking the pawn and then just getting my knights into play. This one, this one. Four minutes left. I guess we should try to berserk the next one. I guess depending on opponent. I'm not gonna try something crazy, I think. Okay, let's move this knight up here. At this point, I'm actually just hoping to flag him, because I'm not entirely sure where all my pieces are. Maybe time for one more game. We're fighting for, I don't know, at best maybe a fourth place. That's pretty disappointing. Yeah, that draw really messed up. If I had won that game, things would have looked pretty good. Okay, let's risk something. So no second guessing this time. You make a mistake, you pay the price. But no thinking for 10 seconds for a move. Okay. The guy didn't want to play. That's interesting. Because now we might have time for a very quick checkmate. Within reach of fourth place. No games. Okay, let's check out the chat.
Arjan. Yeah, maybe I'll get Arjan to stream. He should be interested. Disappointing score playing blindfolded. Yeah, I'm guessing actually you were ironic, right? Do you remember my commentary on seven deadly chess sins? Human biased moves. My commentary? Is that Rosen? No. Missed the fork. I missed the fork, probably. Yeah, it doesn't look like we're getting another game. I'm sorry, everybody. It turns out, playing as slowly as you do in a blindfold game, you're not really fighting to win the tournament. Not even close. You can see these guys have been berserking a little bit. Borrow mods. They are really that short in demand? No, or short in supply, I guess is the right phrase. Okay. That was okay. We won almost all the games. One draw. But we're spending too much time to fight for the tournament win. Blind bullet next time? I don't know. Blind bullet I think is too much. Way too much. Seeing the board and crushing the field. Yeah, maybe next time. I think I'm gonna have to go to bed now. Regular bullet? Next time, maybe. Okay. Good night, everybody.